Today marks a very important day. The big install begins. That's right, winter's finally here and I'm gonna start installing my 48 volt system. And today we're gonna be pulling some 8 gauge PV wire.
So we got 500 feet of PV wire. We'll be running it from the test array through this 1¼ inch conduit. To the end of the conduit, about 120 feet, through the wall, and finally terminating through this liquid-tight conduit. So the first thing we're going to do is figure out where we're going to punch our hole through the wall to the outside. So this is our irrigation line, and I think it's probably safe to say we'll use the same plane, and we'll just go across here to about there. Definitely don't want to be in line with that. So right about there should be good. All right, so from our irrigation PVC there, it's about 44 inches to our conduit and another foot where we're gonna drill our hole into our wall. And check out this, guys. What do you think this is? You know what this is? Put it in the comments. But I'm gonna tell you. So my dad was a plant operator at NV Energy, and this blade came out of a gas turbine generator. This is a final stage blade, so it's at the back of the turbine. This came out of a model 7FA generator, and this is a replacement blade, and they cost about $15,000 new. I don't know what blade number this was, and I can't remember how many blades are in the turbine, but I want to say more than 50, less than 100. Interesting to think that this very blade could have helped produce power that I consumed, and now I'm trying to replace. How ironic. Dude, I just realized this conduit has been adapted down. This was here before I bought the house, and this looks like 2-inch conduit. And then it's been adapted down to 1¼ inches, which is what I'm having to deal with now. And I'm taking it from 1¼ inches down to 3/4 inch. So this is definitely not to code, but everything else actually will be to code. But again, this is a temporary setup. I'm only using it until I get my panels mounted on the roof. Okay, so since the 8 gauge PV wire is pretty heavy, we're going to be running 2 nylon strings through the conduit.
The old pull string has been in the conduit for over 10 years. I do not want to risk it breaking.
I get one chance at this. Alright, here we go. Uh-oh, that's not good. Oh, that's good. Oh no. There it is, look at that. Both of them. This string looks pretty good actually. Probably could have used it, but I didn't want to risk it.
So I don't have a spooler, so this is gonna have to work. True DIY. Ah, pretty good. Look at this wire, it's crazy. I use 8 gauge because the run in the conduit is 120 feet. So we want to try to reduce the voltage drop as much as possible. So what you want to do is make a loop like this and then tape this and then tie your string around the loop and then tape that so it's extra strong. It's a good thing we have a 2-inch conduit because this making this loop right here is gonna create quite a bit of friction going through the conduit. So I can probably get away with this for the first run, but I might have a little bit of trouble with the second cable. Now we'll take our pull string, put it through the loop. I know, it's a horrible knot. I don't know how to do knots. And we'll tape that off as well. All right, I got it started. Let's see if I can make it pull. That happened. That bend right there, it's already very tough. So that bend right there, the wire needs to go straight down, so. I wrapped the cable so it's coming up and over, so hopefully it goes straight in. But still, I really need someone manning the spool here because pulling it at the other end is nearly impossible. Let's give it a try. All right, so that's not working well. I'm gonna call in my buddy. He's gonna come over in about 20 minutes, so. Okay, I got my buddy from down the street and he's gonna help me do this pull. Ready, man?
Yes, let's do it.
Look at this. Two cables, two 8-gauge PVs with three pole strings. Two pulling and one extra. Hey, go. It's getting tough over there, right?
Yeah. I know, it's almost here. I got it! Woo! Yeah. I got the two cables.
Yeah. I do not have a drill bit that will go through the wall, so I'll be right back. Okay, so I picked up a 1-inch hole saw drill bit and an 18-inch installer drill bit. Call that a drill bit? Now that's a drill bit. Name the movie. Bad impression. So what we want to do, we need this long bit to make a nice clean hole on the other side. Then we're going to come into the other side with this hole saw drill bit, and so it'll be nice and clean on the stucco side. Here we go. I've already verified nothing's there through secretive methods. All right, now it's time for our hole saw drill bit. All right. These houses are so crappy. You could, with one blow of a good sledgehammer, you could blow right through the wall. That's how crappy these houses are. Okay, now for the tricky part. Take our cables, feed it through here, and then we'll feed it through our conduit into the garage. I kept this as long as possible because I'm going to use this for my 48-volt system. Right now, I just want to get my 24-volt system moved into the garage.
I think it went through. Would have been easier to go through this way, but I was worried it wouldn't work. But anyway.
Okay, I got my wife on the other end, so should be easier. Here you go. Just to hold the pole string in place. Alright, so that's been a long time coming. Now we're going to install some 8-gauge MC4 connectors. Make sure you use 8-gauge connectors with 8-gauge wire. These can handle 40 amps versus the 10-gauge ones can handle only 30 amps. So when I label these cables, I labeled the positive only. So this does absolutely no good for me because I don't know what the other side is. So we're going to have to figure out what the polarity is after we get the connectors on. So look at the size of these ferrules. These things are heavy duty, super heavy duty. This is an 8-gauge and this is a 10-gauge. Look at the, here's our full barrel, see that? And this is just how these little ears that fold over. That's crazy, the difference. I can feel the difference in the weight. If you haven't seen the video, I have a video that explains how to do MC4 connectors, so I'm not going to do it, and I'm not going to explain it right now in detail. So if you want to see the video, check it out right here. Man, so we'll check our depth here. It's a little shallow. So this style crimper is not going to work for those closed barrel ferrules. Definitely different to work with. Again, I'm not using the right crimper, so do not use these.
So the closed barrel ferrule, closed barrel crimpers are better because it's gonna, this puts one indentation on basically one side, but this one will actually do it on all four sides equally. Put on our end cap. Should snap on like that, and this should not come off. With the 10 gauge connectors, you could just grab this and push this in, but there's a little guard right here, see? You actually have to use their little spanner that goes inside there, unlocks it. When I mentioned, I don't know which side is gonna be positive or negative on the other side, we're gonna use this small 100 watt panel, and it's like 4 p.m. This panel is completely shaded. So it should produce enough voltage, just a tiny amount of voltage, that we can use our multimeter on the other side to figure out the correct polarity. I do have a prober, but what's the fun of that? I'd never do this with high voltage. This produces like 20 volts. And at this time of day, it's gonna produce, it might produce like 10 volts. Okay, so we got the other ends and we got them stripped. You can see there's nothing there, hardly. Barely even creates a spark. We just put our probes here. And here. So that's positive. And this will be read, this will read negative. So that's negative voltage. We know this wire right here is the positive. Charging when the battery goes too low. As odd as it may sound, I'm gonna miss hearing the sound of the inverter in the house. I don't know. I could listen to it and know how much watts I was getting from the solar. That's how well I knew the thing. Alright, that's right. 15 watts. At this time of day, yeah, I can usually get about 15 watts. Alright guys, well that's it for this video, and yeah, those crimps might be a little bit questionable, but I'll keep an eye on them and see how things go. See you on the next one.